Mushrooms can really mess with your head, and not just in a like, whoa, I can hear colors way. It turns out certain mushrooms, and I'm not talking about the magical kind, can give you something even gnarlier than a bad trip. A recent study from the French Alps suggests that eating the wrong fungi can trigger the neurodegenerative disease, ALS, which is scary. Some people think of ALS as a genetic disease, so the idea that your lunch could be involved is unwelcome news. Even scarier, it's not the only part of the world where a large group of ALS patients has emerged due to the local diet. Fortunately, scientists are on the case, and they're beginning to understand what foods are behind these mysterious ALS clusters. The first step in untangling what might cause ALS is understanding what the disease is in the first place. ALS, or amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, is a neurological disorder where patients gradually lose control of their muscles due to the degeneration of the motor neurons. As the condition progresses, patients often struggle to speak, eat, and move. Even if this is all sounding familiar from your participation in the 2014 Ice Bucket Challenge, ALS is a complicated disease, and scientists aren't totally sure what's going on with it. There are at least 25 different genetic risk factors that increase a person's chance of developing ALS, including mutations in two genes that code for proteins found in motor neurons. But genetics can only explain about 10% of all ALS cases. Most cases are sporadic, which means they appear without any known family history or genetic cause, so there must be something else going on. We obviously know that genes aren't the only thing that impacts people's health. Environmental factors play an important role too. For example, respiratory diseases are more common in places with lots of air pollution, and eating 10-day-old potato salad can make you very sick. One of the clues that a disease has an environmental cause is the existence of a geographic cluster, a specific place where the disease is much more common. And while ALS is a rare disease overall, there are places where it is tens, hundreds, or even a thousand times more common than it should be. The most famous ALS cluster occurred in Guam about 70 years ago. It appeared and disappeared within 3 decades. Now, Guam's indigenous Chamorro people were familiar with ALS, or at least an ALS-like disease, for hundreds of years, but the number of cases skyrocketed after World War II. In 1954, ALS was an estimated 25 times more common in Guam than the rest of the world. Globally, there are about 2 new cases of the disease per 100,000 people per year. Guam had 50 new cases per 100,000 people. So what changed to cause this cluster? The 1940s, 50s, and 60s were a tough time for Guam due to the Japanese occupation, wartime disruption of shipping routes, and large-scale shifts in the island's economy. The islanders often didn't have enough to eat, and many relied more heavily on local food sources to fill their bellies. One in particular that became more popular was a plant called fadang. Fadang is a traditional food source for the people of Guam, but consumption skyrocketed during this period. As it turns out, the plant's seeds, which can be ground into flour, contain large amounts of psychosin, a neurotoxin. Psychosin breaks down into a chemical called methyl azoxymethanol, or MAM, and MAM alone damages DNA and interferes with the normal cell cycle. To make matters even worse, MAM breaks down into formaldehyde, which you may know from jars of creepy preserved animals in biology class. Formaldehyde also damages DNA and is already directly linked to ALS. So while it's impossible to say with 100% certainty, it's pretty widely accepted that this increased consumption of fadang was responsible for Guam's ALS cluster. The good news is this cluster didn't last forever. By the 1980s, the trend started to reverse as the economic situation in Guam improved and reliable food imports allowed islanders to diversify their diet. Today, ALS has all but disappeared from the territory. No one born after the 1960s has developed the disease, and armed with the knowledge of the link between ALS and fadang, we can be fairly confident that this particular cluster has been eliminated once and for all. But Guam isn't the only region to experience increased rates of ALS. A more recent ALS cluster occurred thousands of miles away and decades later in a small hamlet called Montchavant, nestled in the French Alps. In 2009, after diagnosing a third case of ALS in the small town of only 200 people, a local doctor called in a team of researchers to figure out what was going on. Going door to door, they discovered that there weren't just three people with ALS in Montchavin and the surrounding area, but 14, which is equivalent to an astronomical incidence of 7,000 cases per 100,000 people. Using a combination of interviews, genetic tests, and environmental screening, the team ruled out genetic factors as well as obvious contaminants like heavy metals from the abandoned mines nearby or the snow inducer chemical used by the ski resort. And Fadang obviously couldn't be the culprit again. The tropical plant wouldn't last a minute in the Alps. But there was a different dietary quirk that linked all the local ALS patients, their taste for raw wild mushrooms. Foraging mushrooms can be risky if you aren't 100% sure what you've got. One species to watch for in the French Alps is the toxic false morel, which is easily mistaken for the tasty true morel. Among other things, false morels that haven't been cooked contain hydrazones, which break down into DNA-damaging compounds like MMH and MFH. Guess what MMH and MFH break down into? Formaldehyde. So based on this French study, false morels and Fadang seem to have very similar long-term health effects, including triggering ALS. Different dish, same devastating impact on your nervous system. These stories emphasize how much more there is to ALS besides genetics. To understand it, we have to look beyond the obvious to observe cultural and environmental patterns that can explain what DNA can't. And while you don't have to worry about those mushrooms on your pizza, you probably should think twice about heading out to the Alps on that foraging mission. At the very least, make sure to cook them all the way through.